the song of the redeemed, rising from the African plain. It's the song of the forgiven, drowning out the Amazon rain. The song of Asian believers, filled with God's holy fire.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
It's great to be with y'all this morning for y'all's all-school mass together, especially first time since COVID. My brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins so as to celebrate reverently these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, you set St. Rose of Lima on fire with your love, so that secluded from the world in the austerity of a life of penance, she might give herself to you alone. Grant, we pray, that through her intercession we may tread the paths of life on earth and drink at the stream of your delights in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the beginning of the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the Church of the Thessalonians, and God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, unceasingly calling to mind your work of faith, labor of love, and endurance in hope of our Lord Jesus Christ, before our God and Father, knowing, brothers and sisters loved by God, how you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit, and with much conviction. You know what sort of people we were among you for your sake. In every place your faith in God has gone forth, so that we have no need to say anything. For they themselves openly declare about us what sort of reception we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols, to serve the living and true God, and to await his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who delivers us from the coming wrath. The word of the Lord. The Lord takes delight in his people. Sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King. The Lord takes delight in his people. Let them praise his name in the festive dance. Let them sing praise to him with tremble and harp. For the Lord loves his people, and he adorns the lowly with victory. The Lord takes delight in his people. Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is the glory of all his faithful. Alleluia. The Lord takes delight in his people.
Alleluia, alleluia. My sheep hear my voice, says the Lord. I know them, and they follow me. Alleluia, Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the crowds and to his disciples, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You lock the kingdom of heaven before men. You do not allow yourselves to enter, nor do you allow entrance to those trying to enter. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You traverse sea and land to make one convert, and when that happens, you make him a child of Gehenna twice as much as yourselves. Woe to you, blind guides, who say, 'If one swears by the temple, it means nothing. But if one swears by the gold of the temple, one is obligated.' Blind fools, which is greater, the gold or the temple that made the gold sacred? And when you say, 'If one swears by the altar, it means nothing. But if one swears by the gift of the altar, one is obligated.' You blind ones, which is the greater gift? The altar or the gift, or the altar that makes the gift sacred? One who swears by the altar swears by it and all that is upon it. One who swears by the temple swears by it and by him who dwells in it. One who swears by heaven swears by the throne of God and by him who is seated on it." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So I guess this being our first all-school mass, I better keep this homily short and make it good, or y'all boot me out of here, right? On a rail. You know, I listen to these words of Paul, of St. Paul, and that we hear in our first reading today, Paul writing to one of his beloved communities, saying that he gives thanks for these ones that have been given to him by God, those who were chosen. And I can't help but identifying with him, being here as we stand together, as we pray together in our first all-school mass, being now your chaplain, being new, this my first year, I give great thanks to God that not only that I get to now be here to serve you as your chaplain, but also that we're all here together, because it's been a really rough past year and a half. And the words of Scripture speak to us in these ways, oftentimes surprisingly. And you know, we also heard in the Word today something which I know will be interesting to everyone here in this room, which is we've heard Jesus criticize hypocrisy. We all know what a hypocrite is. Someone who says one thing to us, but then does something completely opposite of what they have said. And I bet there isn't a single one of us here that approves of seeing someone be a hypocrite, especially when we are the ones on the receiving end of that hurtful kind of betrayal. You know, the word hypocrite comes from the Greek hypocrisis, which literally means to play a theatrical part, or in other words, to act. And none of us wants an act, especially when it comes to those things that are most important to us as humans: happiness, relationships, and connections. And yet, because of the human flaws that come about from original sin, that human tendency to do evil because it seems good for me at the moment, without thinking of others, without thinking of the harm that these selfish actions and desires cause, hypocrisy, or acting, is all too common, even when there are good intentions underneath it, so that we end up hurting each other. We end up letting each other down more often than we would care to admit. But there is one person that we can always depend on to level with us, and that is Jesus Christ, our God, our Lord. In him there is no act, there is no hypocrisy, there is no playing the theatrical role. There is only total, reliable truth. Truth which is at the same time love. What we see there on the projector. Jesus Christ, our God, who put himself on the cross for us because he wants to give us all that is good, all that is healing, all that is saving. He is the truth that wants to connect with us, that wants to relate with us. In a word, Jesus is the very definition of authenticity. And receiving his grace, receiving his divine life, working in our souls, it transforms us and it allows us to be authentic as well. And when we accept, when we receive that grace, we are empowered to look at others with that same authenticity. And it is then that we can often understand the real meaning, the depths of the damage that hypocrisy works in our own lives. And we also understand the times when we have been hypocrites, how we fell into that. It has always been because we, just as it is with those who may hurt us, have lived, for whatever reason, apart from that authentic freedom that comes from reliance on and our connection with Jesus Christ. I remember for myself, when I was in your shoes, in those seats, when I was in high school, albeit at that place down on Shalford Road we won't talk about, but when I was there, I remember in high school that growing in my relationship with the Lord helped me to understand these things more deeply. And while this understanding does not change the things that we have experienced that have been done to us, or the pain or the disappointment that we may feel or that we may cause, it does help us to heal, help us to be happier. It helps us to live differently, to make different choices, to desire better, holier things for ourselves and for others. That transformation is real freedom. And I guarantee you that if you open your heart more to Christ, you will experience that same freedom, and that authenticity and the freedom with which you live will touch a lot of lives for the better. It will transform not only yourselves, but it will transform this school. It will transform the world that soon enough you will be responsible for changing for the better. I just want to share with you a brief prayer from Mother Teresa, which I think is the most wonderful prayer that captures this spirit of authenticity and this spirit of freedom that God calls us to live. People are often unreasonable and self-centered. Forgive them anyway. If you are kind, people may accuse you of ulterior motives. Be kind anyway. If you are successful, you will win some false friends and true enemies. Succeed anyway. If you are honest, people may cheat you. Be honest anyway. What you spend years building, someone may destroy overnight. Build anyway. If you find serenity and happiness, they may be jealous. Be happy anyway. The good you do today, people will often forget tomorrow. Do good anyway. Give the world the best you have, and it may never be enough. Give your best anyway. As we come to receive the Lord, we come to encounter his love, this wonderful divine beauty and authenticity and freedom right here in this altar. Let's ask him for the grace to make good use of what he gives us in the way that we live together as a Blessed Trinity School community each and every day. And so now we stand to offer our prayers and petitions before God our Father. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray for our Archbishop Gregory Hartmeyer. We pray for the clergy. We pray for the whole church, that we may each be all authentic witnesses, authentic testimony to the freedom, to the authentic love of Jesus Christ in the world. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all those who are sick and suffering, especially all those who are affected in any way by the COVID pandemic, that they may know God's closeness, God's love for them. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all of you, our students, faculty, and staff, the Blessed Trinity community, as we begin this new year. May we be inspired by many graces. May we be strengthened and encouraged by the love of God that brings us all together each and every day. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray in a special way for all those in our community who are sick and suffering, who are not with us here today. We pray for Miss Kelly Todd. We pray for Michael Bell. We pray for all those in our community who are not with us today, that they might still know that they are close to us, that we pray for them, and that the Lord is close to them. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we offer our prayers and petitions before you today. We are confident that you hear us, and that you will answer our prayers in accordance with your most holy will. And we ask all these things through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we proclaim your wonders, O Lord, in the Virgin Blessed Rose of Lima, we humbly implore your majesty that as her merits are pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits, you crown your own gifts. By their way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you give us companionship. By their intercession, sure support. So that encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us and win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and archangels and with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Gregory John our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are high.
Come thou fount of every blessing, to my heart to sing thy praise.
Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise.
Thou my vision, O Lord of my heart, not be
teach me some melodious sonnet, sung by flaming tongues above. Waking or sleeping, thy presence, my light.
Here's my heart, Lord, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above.
Let us pray. Renewed by partaking of this divine gift, we pray, O Lord our God, that by the example of the Blessed Rose of Lima, bearing in our body the death of Jesus, we may strive to hold fast to you alone. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. It's great to be with y'all today. Briefly, I actually met some BT grads last night at Georgia Tech at our like 9 p.m. Mass. So today's like the first day of school at Georgia Tech. So if you remember to like say a prayer for us and our community, I would really appreciate it and know that I'm praying for y'all. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
the kind of faith it takes to climb out of this boat and then under the crashing waves.